Hello, I'm Carl Stefanovic.
And this is Today.
It's good to have your company, folks. A little day drunk with Morgan Evans later on. Can't wait to catch up with the Aussie superstar. But first, to breaking news out of Western Sydney, where a major police operation has just wrapped in Prairie Wood.
Let's go straight to Today correspondent Lara Vella at the scene. Lara, what can you tell us?
Sarah and Carl, good morning to you. This siege operation here in Sydney's southwest at Prairie Wood has been unfolding for about 6 hours here. There were at least 20 police officers on the scene, including specialist officers, tactical police, negotiators as well, alongside paramedics. We understand that the initial call for this incident came in at around 11 p.m. last night. We do believe, Sarah and Carl, it was in relation to a domestic violence incident. I can tell you, though, in the last half an hour or so, tactical police officers here at the scene, that is when they have made their move. They've kicked down the door at a property just behind me on this street, you can see, and they have arrested one individual, a man, and we understand he was peacefully taken into custody. It is my understanding, Carl and Sarah, that this person of interest does not, in fact, live at the property, and inside the home was a woman. At this stage, Carl and Sarah, no reports of injuries, but good news, specialist officers have safely wrapped up this siege here at Prairie Wood.
Good news indeed. Thanks so much, Lara.
The search is on for West Australia's next Premier after Mark McGowan shocked the nation by announcing he's quitting politics. Surrounded by his colleagues and wife, he confirmed his time in the top job will come to a close by the end of the week. After record popularity, Mark McGowan gave one reason for his decision.
The truth is I'm tired. Extremely tired. In fact, I'm exhausted. The role of political leadership doesn't stop. It's relentless. It comes with huge responsibility.
Let's bring in Carl Langdon from 6PR in Perth. Carl, good morning to you. This was a huge shock for the entire state and country.
Yeah, Carl, Sarah, good morning to you. It was, and there's a lot of mixed reaction. I think there's a lot of people that are out there wondering, is there more to this? Are there other reasons? We know that political life is a public life, and we know that it's always going to be confrontational, which was one of the interesting parts that he said in the press conference yesterday, is that he doesn't like confrontation. Well, I must say, throughout his tenure as Premier of this state, I think he's been embroiled in plenty of that.
That is for certain. And the race is on now to find his successor. Who will it be?
Yeah, well, look, Roger Cook, he's the Deputy Premier. He's now the Tourism Minister. He was the Health Minister. That portfolio has now been taken on by Amber Jane Sanderson. Now, she's been embroiled in controversy as well because of our health system, which has been under a fair bit of turmoil here with record ramping at the moment. And then, of course, you've got the straight shooter in Rita Saffiotti. Now, she's got a lot of popularity because of the way that she speaks. She doesn't mind coming out and having a crack, Carl. So I wouldn't be surprised if she's the one that they hone in on to be the main target for the job.
All right, talk to you soon, Carl. Thank you.
Footage has emerged from inside a speeding car believed to be involved in a horrific crash which claimed 4 lives in regional Victoria. According to the Herald Sun, the video posted to social media shows a vehicle travelling 130 kilometres an hour along a narrow road. 3 teenagers and a woman died in the high-speed crash near Hamilton. The demolition process of a Sydney building destroyed in a massive fire will begin today. Police will bring in dogs to search the wreckage, with grave fears for 2 homeless people who remain unaccounted for. Victoria's conservation regulator is this morning investigating an influencer event at a Melbourne nightclub where reptiles were passed around as props. 2 Wrongs in South Yarra has been accused of animal cruelty after posting images to social media of revelers holding snakes and kissing baby crocodiles. The venue has since deleted the photos from its online pages. Crowds attending a rodeo in Western Australia have been forced to run for their lives after a bull managed to break loose at the event. Footage captures the moment line dancers realise what's happening, screaming as the animal goes on a rampage. A young girl and a man in his 30s were taken to hospital suffering suspected fractures.
Debate will continue in Canberra today over the Voice to Parliament referendum following the Prime Minister's impassioned plea to the public. Let's go live to Nine Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards in Canberra. Eliza, Anthony Albanese delivered a keynote speech in Adelaide overnight.
He did, Sarah, and he used this speech to take aim at the scare campaign surrounding the Voice to Parliament, saying he believes they greatly underestimate Australians. And the PM spoke about the potential for the referendum to be a moment of unity and reconciliation with First Nations people.
Let us write the beginning of a better chapter, a chapter in which we turn hope into reality, to walk with us in a movement of the Australian people for a better future is at last accepted. Together we can do just that, and together we will.
Sarah, Parliament House is being lit up for Reconciliation Week, while inside MPs will get back into debating The Voice today. Most of the Liberal Party is in the no camp, claiming an Indigenous advisory body would re-racialise Australia. But the opposition will support legislation enabling the referendum. That's expected to pass the lower house this week before the national vote is held between October and December.
OK, Eliza, thank you.
A Gold Coast man is counting his lucky stars this morning after prying himself out of a crocodile's jaws in far north Queensland. Today, Queensland reporter Mia Glover joins us now from the Goldie. Mia, terrifying.
Absolutely, Carl. This is an extraordinary tale, and the fact that he's managed to able to walk away pretty much unscathed, bar a few puncture wounds, is just remarkable. His name is Marcus McGowan. He's 51 years old. He says he was snorkeling with his wife and friends while staying at Haggerston Island Resort. It's a luxury accommodation spot there up in the Cape York, some 600 k's away from Cairns or so. Marcus says he was out in the clear blue waters when all of a sudden he felt like he was being attacked by a shark. That's what he thought, but then it instead turned out to be a croc. Now, in a statement, he says, "I was attacked from behind by a saltwater crocodile, which got its jaws around my head." And then he added he was able to lever its jaws open just far enough to get his head out. He then says the croc tried to have another go at him, Carl, but he managed to push it away, although it did bite his hands as it swam away. This is just remarkable, the fact that he is able to tell us exactly what happened and the fact that his whole head was in the jaws of the croc. He has, like I mentioned, suffered some puncture wounds. He's still in Cairns Hospital, but he's in a stable condition. And this is the fifth crocodile attack to occur in the region in just 2 months.
Mia, thank you.
Let's get a look at the markets for you now. On Wall Street, the Dow Jones is up and the S&P 500 is also in the green. At home, the All Ords closed up yesterday. In London, the FTSE ended in the green as well. Commodities and gold is at $1,900 an ounce and oil is at $76 a barrel.
Now, talk about living on the edge. This man has broken the record for Italy's highest city tightrope walk. Andrea Loreni walked a length of 205 metres on the tightrope, which was suspended 14 metres above the ground. And it had a political message, with organisers claiming it was a metaphor for the perilous journey humanity is facing with climate change. Looks a bit scary, doesn't it?
Mm. What are the other fellas doing on there?
Who knows, Alex?
Just
they
watching?
Differently in Italy.
What are they doing there?
Keeping an eye, I think.
Just keeping an eye on things?
Mm.
Ah, good stuff.